Hello friends, today we will discuss various methods to build e-learning websites with and without coding. As an educational professional and businessman, you would have faced a dilemma while launching an e-learning website. What tool and tech to use for it? How much of coding skills would be needed? How the options compare in feature and cost? How much customization would we be able to do? What my competitors and similar sites are using? Here we present a brief guide on all the possible options. The article is actually based on our experience with hundreds of e-learning websites that we have come across while working with them in our company, and our technical analysis of some globally prominent e-learning websites, as an example, Udemy, Coursera. The categorization of website development into four methods is primarily on the basis of coding skills required to build a site. We have then tried to explain pros and cons for each of them on the basis of following: technical skill, features, scale, customization, cost, time, in-house versus outsource. A separate section of video discusses options to use for course video streaming on an e-learning website. So here are the four options to build a site. First is code from raw, using languages like PHP, ASP, Java, Node.js. Second is using open source options like Moodle, WordPress, Joomla, which require quite little of coding. Third is to use ready-to-launch generic website themes provided by sites like Weebly, Wix. Fourth is to use ready-to-launch teaching template sites like Teachable, Webanywhere. Let's start with the first option, code from raw. This is primarily done by individuals or businesses who have developer in their team or outsourcing it with major objective to serve a large number of students with lot of custom features in place. In terms of technical skill, good level of coding is required. Each part of site, like user management, course pages, has to be coded from scratch. PHP, ASP, Node.js, all are good technologies to work in. Node.js is the newest one, while PHP is currently being used by a lot of popular sites. There is no strictness amongst choosing these languages. It is recommended to go with the language in which the development team is most comfortable and experienced with. Server and database has also to be set up along with these sites. For large cases, a dedicated server in your own country or something global like AWS would be good. For small cases, shared hosting by GoDaddy can also be good enough. Regarding features and customization, since the entire site is coded by your team or outsourced company, time and cost has to go into development of all the features. But at the same time, it means that you have everything you want. As an example, you want your viewer to be logged out exact after 300 hours of their total login, then it can be done. If you want to get the exact video time when each of the viewers stops playing video, it can again be done. It is difficult to do these type of customizations with other options which we are going to mention after this. In terms of cost, if you are outsourcing, the cost is considerably higher than other options, as it requires full development. It is great if you have a developer in your own team. The cost of maintenance and support is generally not much for this. Regarding time, it will generally take around 2 to 3 months of time to get ready with a full-fledged e-learning website. To discuss scale effects, for less than 1000 expected users annually, this option is not recommended, as the cost and time involved do not comply with the risk of starting up for such a small scale. We have seen all the sites with the number of annual customers in range of 10,000 to millions using this as an option to build a site. Reason for this is that as you grow in your customer base, you start to face feature demands specific to your student demographics and courses you are selling. Then it is easier to customize if the site backend is in your or outsourced company control. Again, as a suggestion, for annual customers going greater than 1 lakh a year, it is recommended to have one or two developers in-house with you. In case of urgencies, of course, your own team will be better able to cope up with the requirements. Now coming to second choice, that is open source options like Moodle, WordPress, Joomla and Drupal. In terms of technical skill, apart from one-time server setup which can be done by a freelancer, these options does not require any coding skills. We have seen independent artists, teachers easily set up their own sites on Moodle, WordPress and cater to students worldwide. In terms of feature and customization, basic student and course management features are already provided in Moodle. If you are using WordPress and Joomla, using themes and plugins like Sensei, Guru, eMember, Driven Concurrent Login, Video Cipher, most of common requirements for membership management, course page customizations can be done. Many of good themes are paid, while lot of good plugins are free. Very detailed customization like restricting exact login time of student, getting video playback time of students might not be possible with this. But the main offerings like restricting membership time, payment processing, drip content can easily be done with the plugins. In terms of cost, these are open source options, so it is free to start with. And you only pay for the themes and plugins that you use. That also only one time. It is quite affordable and we do not see any educators bothering much about small costs on themes and plugins that provide them major functionalities. If you're still not sure about how your business will shape up, how much students will sign up, it is better to use this option instead of coding from raw. The time to launch can range from 15 days to 1 month. To discuss scale effects, if the number of subscribed students you expect on your site are not going to shoot past 10,000, it is good to be on such platforms. You might face scaling and customization problem if the number shoots past 10,000. Coming to the third option, which is ready to launch theme websites like Weebly, Wix, Squarespace. These are the easiest low-cost alternatives to launch a website in very cheap prices within a week. There is very little customization possible and most of these tools are not particularly built for e-learning. Though some of these companies do provide certain customizations for e-learning, but most of the companies don't. We have seen some independent teachers who don't expect more than 100 users to pay for their course using it. It is quite less of a hassle and no pain to wallet. This can be used as a trial and experimentation to start with. Coming to the last option, which is ready to launch e-learning website templates from Teachable, Webanywhere. These are nowadays quite popular tools to go live in just few days with all the feature sets ready. Sites like Teachable, Webanywhere offer ready-to-use e-learning themes, student management, media text edition, membership access, server, database as a functionality. There is no coding involved. The costs are reasonable and directly proportional to the number of students you are going to have. In terms of feature and customization, though these sites offer a lot of features at one go which are sufficient for around 50% of course creators, but for many course creators, if they require customizations on the UI, design and security front, these companies are not able to cater to it specifically. As an example, you can't restrict the login time, you can't custom set up particular student comment section on a page where you want to. Thus, reviews should be taken before going any of this option as your whole business relies in the fate of these companies. In terms of scale effects, again as mentioned in second case, it is recommended to set up your own system on some CMS if number of students is going to shoot more than 1000. Or built a scratch coded site like in PHP if the number is going to be above 10,000. Now I have a tip for all of you. Sometimes it is a great idea to learn from your friends and competitors. If you see someone similar to you in same space and want to check out what they are using for their course website, you can do with it a very helpful tool built with .com. It analyzes the text check on which any website is based and presents it to you. If 8 out of 10 of your competitors are using the same framework, then sure, it is a good thing to check out. We are summarizing the study with a matrix to compare the 4 possible ways to design an e-learning website. You can pause the video to have a look in detail while I speak only of the conclusions here. First, if you are looking to code a site from raw, then the choice of technology depends on comfort of your development team. It is ideal for large custom required sites. Open source options like WordPress, Moodle, Joomla optimizes cost, features and control of all the amongst options. It is the most popular option which I have seen. Options like Webanywhere, Teachable are good for individual teachers, but you have to give up on certain customizations. It is also affordable. Sites like Weebly, Wix are good for experimentation. It is better to choose amongst other 3 options if you are going for a full-fledged e-learning portal. Coming to the last section, that is streaming e-learning videos and protection from piracy. Reason we are specifically including a different section on video streaming for education is because, firstly, video courses are typically the lifeline of any e-learning portal. Secondly, video streaming and safeguarding video content from piracy is a major technical challenge, which the 4 options discussed don't solve inherently. Most of e-learning websites use some premium third-party video streaming provider to cater to their streaming needs. Streaming bufferless for HD worldwide and ensuring smooth delivery to regions with slow connections is a major problem. YouTube is quite good in this aspect but lacks business-friendly customizations. Vimeo has a B2B offering that is quite popular and is decent in streaming experience. But both YouTube and Vimeo use standard streaming protocols to deliver video content, and thus lot of free plugins and downloaders are able to grab and pirate the videos. Something more custom built for premium videos, providing higher security and flexibility to manage video related features is needed. Here comes Video Cipher. Encrypted streaming with viewer specific watermarking on a multi-bitrate player is a good option provided by Video Cipher. No downloader or plugin can grab content streamed through us. Our smooth streaming optimizations ensure that videos play smooth even in low internet speed areas of, say, India or Africa. Encrypted streaming, analytics, API, custom player, watermarking, dashboard, all in one go. Video Cipher has e-learning and media customers across 6 continents and 30 plus countries. We are a proud winner of Streaming Media Europe Reader's Choice Award for 2016. You can visit our site to have a free full version trial. Also, we would be happy to have your feedbacks and questions in the comment section below or on our site contact. You are also welcome to share your experience with above technologies and any interesting insights. Happy teaching!